Hello everyone, this is Acreate, the channel for game development and more. In this tutorial I will explain how to make a simple Pac-Man clone in Game Maker Studio 2. We start by importing a sprite for a tile set. I resize the sprite image to 1152 to 768 and create a tile set out of the sprite, with a tile width and height of 32 by 32. Check out my tutorial about tile maps if you want more information about tile sets. Open the room and add the tileset layer and the tileset we just created. Resize the room to 768 to 1028 and use the tileset to visualize the Pac-Man maze. We need to make a new sprite for creating the collision. Click on Edit Image and select a color with the Paint Bucket tool to make a square. And fill it. With this new sprite we will create a new object for the collision. Assign the sprite and uncheck its visibility. Go back to the room and drag a collision block in the room and resize its size. Then fill in the same way all the unreachable spots in your maze. Create a new sprite for the small coins. Select Edit Image and import the image stripe of the small coin. Set the frames per row to 8. Resize the frame width and height to 16 by 16 and click on Convert. Set its frames rate a bit slower to like 5 frames per second or so. And rescale the image by 32 by 32. Repeat the same steps for the big coin. Import sprite image set, set frames per second slower and resize to 32. Before adding the coins in the scene, we need to make two objects with the same sprites. Reopen the room. Deselect unsnap as we want to place the coins in the center. Drag in the coins, hold Alt to keep on painting with the coins and fill your board. Delete the ones which don't fit the overall outlay of the maze. Lovely, right? Okay, let's add in the Pac-Man. First we will make the sprite for the Pac-Man walk, then use the same comfort settings as with the coins and convert and resize the image by 32 by 32. Duplicate the sprite, double click on it, go to edit image and mirror all frames. Copy the sprite again by Ctrl plus D, click on the image, edit image and rotate all frames clockwise by 90. Duplicate the up sprite, edit the image and flip all frames. Now we have all the animation sprites for our Pac-Man. Open a new object for the Pac-Man. Rename and assign the sprite. Create the event key press left and drag in the function jump to point and set the x to minus 32 and check to relative. Set sprite to change to the left walking sprite. For the right key press we do the same, only we set the x to a 32 positive and relative and set the sprite to the right walking. And for the key pressed up we set a jump to point I value to minus 32 relative and select the sprite for going up. For the key press down we set the I value to a positive 32 relative and so on. Now just add a collision with the wall and set the direction of the Pac-Man on reverse. And all is set for the walking. As the goal for Pac-Man is to collect all the coins, I like to insert a restart function for Pac-Man that when all the coins have been eaten. Then we create a step event and select if instance exists, select the coin and check the not check and drag in the restart room function. So if there's no coin in the scene, the game will restart itself. Create a collision event with the coin and destroy the coins by selecting destroy other. Do the same with the big coin but also add a variable for checking if Pac-Man has eaten the big coin and set its value to true. To make this functional we need to add in some ghosts. Make a new sprite for the red ghost, edit image and import in the same ways as we did before the images. In the properties we scale the ghost to 32 by 32 and apply. Because I want to enhance its collision, I will resize only the sprite size with a resize canvas by 64 by 64. And in the collision mask, we will select collision with the wall image. We do this because we want to have the ghost in the center of the paths in our maze. We do the exact same for the green ghost and the blue ghost. Duplicate the blue ghost and in the edit image, I will just repaint all images with the paint bucket tool into a white slash grayish ghost. This is the animation for when Pac-Man has activated the big coin and can attack the ghosts instead. Make a new object for the ghost. Rename and add a sprite. Make a create event and make a jump to point 352x value by 384. If you use different sizes, you should try out another starting location. Add in a set direction fix and select it to go up and set its speed to type direction 1. Maybe you do remember that I made a collision of the ghost quite big. That is because I want to reset its direction in the collision. Make a collision with the wall and set a direction random and select all four of the directions with a direction speed of 1. Duplicate the red ghost twice and change the sprite to the green and the blue ghost and go back to the room and place them into the red box. I inserted also an extra collision block in the box so that the ghost, when being replaced in the middle box, can get back in an automatical randomized manner. Yes, it's not a bug, but a great feature, right? I just like to keep this tutorial easy, but later I want to go deeper into the AI. Okay, let's go back to our Pac-Man. In the Bitcoin collision, we add in an alarm with a countdown of 200 steps. In the same function, we are also going to change the appearances of all the ghosts. Select Set Sprite Select, and select the ghost and set its sprite to the white ghost image. Do this for all the ghosts. Now make a new alarm function. So when the 200 steps are made, then we are going to set the spinning Pac-Man value to false and all the ghosts go back to their original color with using the select sprite function. At last, we should make the tree collision with the ghost with checking if Pac-Man is strong or weak. With the check of spinning Pac-Man is true, in that case we let the ghost jump back to start. And if not, the ghosts have won and the game will restart with restart room. As we use the spinning Pac-Man value in the collision detection, we need to set its starting value in the create function. So set variable spinning Pac-Man to false. Now all is set to play Pac-Man. I hope you liked this tutorial. If so, please give a like, comment and subscribe for more. As I promised that I will continue with a smart AI for the ghost, that will be the next video. I hope to see you in the next tutorial. This was acreategames. Have a nice weekend. Create more. Enjoy more.